Hi, I'm Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're going to make some fried green tomatoes. And if you were with me when I made my visit to the farmer's market, you know that I bought 4 green tomatoes and I hadn't decided exactly what I was going to do with them. And I sort of mentioned maybe some fried green tomatoes, and I had some comments from people who said, yes, I'd like to see some fried green tomatoes. So here we go. You need to wash your tomatoes and then take off the ends. There'll be an end where the stem was, and then there'll be the other end like that, which will be kind of abnormally shaped sometimes, and you want these kind of flat. So you take off both ends. You'll notice one of mine started turning. It was actually ripening up. But that's okay. It doesn't make any difference. One thing that's nice about green tomatoes is that they generally are not going to ripen up on you, and they're going to stay firm for a long time. So I just had these sitting on the counter. This is Tuesday. Is it Tuesday? It's Tuesday. And we bought these on Saturday, and I just had them sitting over here with my fruit. And I noticed last night that this one was beginning to turn, and I thought, well, better make those pretty soon. So here's the way we make them. You need some buttermilk, 3/4 cup that you're gonna put in a dish like this. And it doesn't matter what kind of dish, just something that you'll be able to dip your tomato slices into. For my buttermilk, I use just skim milk and 1 tablespoon roughly, not quite as much because this is only 3/4 cup here. 3/4 tablespoon of lemon juice. Now you may use white vinegar or you may use powder. Go to my quick tip on making buttermilk or making a buttermilk substitute if you need to see that. But this should be 3/4 cup of buttermilk that goes in here. And we're going to season that up. We're going to use salt and pepper, and you can just use regular ground pepper and regular table salt. But I think it's going to be a little nicer if we grind some fresh pepper into our buttermilk. It certainly is giving off a lot of flavor right now, so I think it's going to add some good flavor to our tomato slices. And then for salt, this makes it just a little bit bigger sized salt. And when it sticks to the tomatoes, it makes them a little saltier, tastier. So just to your taste, either sprinkle in the salt and pepper that you need or grind in the salt and pepper that you need, and then let this sit for a minute. And while we're letting that sit, we're going to take a gallon-sized Ziploc bag, and into that we're going to put some self-rising cornmeal mix. It doesn't say mix on here, but that's what it really is. It's a mixture of cornmeal and flour. So this is generally what it looks like. You can get various brands of it. But I need 1/2 cup of, and it doesn't have to be self-rising, just cornmeal mix is fine. 1/2 cup of that, and I need some flour, and this is 1/2 cup of flour. So those are our two staples there that we need. And then we need some flavoring. What I have is garlic powder, and I have 1/2 tablespoon. This measure is 1/2 tablespoon, so I filled it to the top. We'll put that in there. And then you just want a dash of ground red pepper. I put it in this measuring spoon, and I would say this is 1/4 teaspoon, but I did only 1/2 of it, so that's about 1/8 teaspoon. Don't put too much of that. Just a little bit. Just a dash. And then let's close this up. Seal it. Get that sealed. And then we're going to get that in the back. Heat some peanut oil. I've measured out 4 tablespoons, and I'm going to put it in an iron skillet. If you don't have an iron skillet, just any skillet will be fine. It might not turn out exactly the same, but it should be fine. And I've used peanut oil, but you can use any kind of oil that you like to cook with. So I'm heating that up and getting my lineup ready to do the dipping and the shaking of the tomato slices, because once we do that, they immediately go into the hot oil. I'll be right back.
I moved my assembly line over here to the stove because it would be a little difficult for me to move back and forth. So here have I sliced tomatoes. They're sliced at about 1/2 inch. And you can use large tomatoes. Actually, it's hard to find large green tomatoes right now, but they'll be larger in the next couple of weeks, so we can do that later. So I'll be dipping a tomato slice into the buttermilk mixture, and then I'll be shaking it in this bag of crumbs. Well, not really crumbs, but the flour and cornmeal, which is spiced up. Then I'll be putting it into this hot oil. So let's just do one at a time, and I may just do a few for you just for demonstration and get them all later. Remember, first dip it in the buttermilk mixture, then it'll be nice and coated so it'll pick up more of the mixture in here. And when you have that, then see what it looks like? You put it into hot oil. And it should sizzle a bit, and we'll turn that up so it'll sizzle a little more. And we'll work on some
now
more.
At this point, I think the first one I put in was probably this one. You might want to look underneath it. It's not brown enough. Well, I don't want this to take forever, so I'm going to go ahead and turn some of these. And I want to say it's really to your taste. If you like them browner, that's fine. But this look is fine as well. So let me get them all turned over, and I'll cook the other side. Then we'll come back and see what we do from there. My fried green tomatoes look done. I've been checking underneath, and you can see it's even browner there. And if you like more brownness, there's really no firm rule that says they get turned one. You can turn these over and let them go longer. But this is generally what most people would like. So what I'm going to do is just go ahead and take them up to show you the rest of the story. And I'm putting them on a tray that has some paper towel here. And first I'm going to turn this off because it's going to be an empty skillet. I do have more over here that I'll finish up later. Obviously, probably about twice as much left as what I have cooked. So let's just use some kind of spatula. Take these up. Now I put them on this paper toweling to drain because I didn't want them to have extra oil that was unnecessary. So let's take them over and put them on a serving plate. For one individual, probably a serving of two or three would be nice. So we're going to pick out some good looking ones here. These look pretty good. Symmetrical. And then when you serve them, be sure and have some bottled hot sauce. This is hot cayenne pepper sauce. You'll need to shake it up if you've had it in the refrigerator for a while. And you can just have it there ready for people to use. For this person, they might want to have a little on the side here. And just as they slice off individual portions, say a portion like this. That's the way it is textured, in case you're wondering. Looks like that. Just dip it in there. Ooh, got a little more than I intended, but that's gonna be nice and spicy.